Hey everyone, Dale here. So today I'm going to talk about how to sort and organize screws, bolts, nuts, like if they're in a big mess. I know there's different ways of doing this. This is kind of the way I found it easiest. And you can grab a beer or a Coke. I bought this whole bin off of somebody, had a whole bunch of screws and bolts and everything. It's a complete mess. So what I usually do is, what I found the best way to do is just take a handful of it and start sorting. Get yourself some buckets or some tin cans and just put them in your hand and just sort. If you think it's kind of garbage or you don't know what it is, have one bin for that. So throw it in there. Have another bin for anything that's bolt related, like these small bolts. And then if you got bigger bolts, put your bigger bolts here, and then anything screw related goes here. Now, it's not bringing them right down to smallest to largest. That'll be next. Because if you do everything all at once, you're gonna get bored of it, you're gonna get tired of it. So what I found is, sort the junk. Now you got everything in here. Oh, there's a screw there. That screw, see? Already messed up. That screw should go there. So everything is going to be bolt related here, big bolts, screws. So then, once you get all that out of the pail, and I'm almost done, I got to sit around and do a little bit more. You know, when you got nothing to do, sit on the bench outside or something and just do a handful at a time. And you get tired of it, leave it for the day, come back, do some more. You know, is it worth it? Yeah, I think it is, because these screws, like the small ones, and some of them are hard to find. But like your number 14, number 12s screws, and I use them in RVs a lot. You know, for five or six of these, they're like $3.99, $4. So for me to go through and do them, I think it's, you're saving yourself some money. So then what I would do after that is then maybe take one of these and then sort them down further. Have another two cans and then sort them down further. Now once you get them sorted down to that point, that's where I picked up one of these guys. Now, this is metal on the side. I wouldn't buy one that's plastic. I don't like the plastic. I don't even really care for these. But it was on sale. And I thought, what the heck? So I started to sort some of them. Even though there's different sizes in there. But once you start to sort from there, then you can get all these sorted down. Another YouTuber, I think, I found it on YouTube, was... What he did was anytime he went and bought screws, new screws, he would take the label off when he got it, like a new package. He would peel the label off and he would tape it on the front. So then he knew what size of screw it was. And if he ever got empty, he knew to write it down or he could take this bin into the store with him and get more. I thought that was a pretty cool idea. So that's probably what I'm going to do too. But for right now, I've got lots of screws. I just got to sort them all out. So that's my way of doing it. If you guys have any other ideas, leave them in the comments below. I'd love to hear them of how you organize screws, bolts, things like that. That's kind of the way I came up with it. And then you can go down and sort this out even more. Like, do I really need this? You know, it looks like a wire for a wire. Probably not. You know, some of this junk. Do I really need this? Probably not. Into the garbage. So you can sort that down even further. So then it's not overwhelming when you've got a big, bunch of nuts and bolts. The other way I've been doing it, don't look at my mess, is the old way I've done it is with these bins. And they work pretty good. But it's hard to know. You know, you can measure and you can kind of figure out what size they are. But they get messed up, they get disorganized, I go through a lot of screws like this, self-tapping. So these are handy. And I have, another one for LED lights. I have one for washers. And there's more screws. I also have one for electrical components, that sort of thing. So that works, but what this YouTuber, like, what he'll do, for instance, like he'll take this label off carefully then you know it's 8 by 9/16. And you put that right on the cover here, right? So then you know what that is. So then when you get low, you can just take it back in and get some more. So I thought that's a pretty good idea. But and these have worked out well for me. It's just, you know, I want a little bit more organization. So, you know, these are kind of nice because you can just pop these and go. Take them in the truck, wherever, if you're going somewhere. You know, I get a lot of screws that come out in the RVs and that. That's another tip too. If you have a screws that keeps coming loose, especially in a vehicle or something that's going on the road, put some RV silicone or some dense silicone on it and then screw it in. Put a washer on it if you can too, or a lock washer. And chances are that screw ain't going to come back out again. That silicone works great on it. And I just throw them in here and there you go. Yeah, like here's another one of my totes. And this is kind of my electrical, so I've got all, you know, heat shrink, electrical connectors. This works really well. I like this. I got a heat shrink here, you know, eye connectors, breakers, and you know, anything to do with electrical grease, that sort of thing, for working on trailers and that. That works awesome. I don't really think I'd change this too much because I like this grab and go, but with the screws it's a little easier to do something like with a tower, I think. I don't know. I guess what I could do is put the labels on here on the top, what I wanted to, and that would work. And then when I get low, I know what it is. But yeah, so anyway guys, that's my little tip of the day. How to organize screws and bolts. If you have any comments, please leave them below. Like and share. Till the next video, guys. Ciao for now.